Let's begin with arithmetic operators. This is probably the most familiar topic for us, as we pretty much on a daily basis use arithmetic operations like addition and subtraction. Java also uses familiar notations like plus and minus. However, there are certain specific features that are unique to Java, and we will look at them now. Here are the arithmetic operators, and let's look at each of them. First is the addition operator, for which a plus symbol is used. The example shows addition of two literals and assigning the resulting sum to the variable I. There are also a couple of other ways in which a plus operator can be used. One use is a unary plus, which is used to just indicate that a number is positive. Second, it can also be used in concatenating or joining multiple strings, which we will see later while discussing strings. Next, for subtraction, a minus symbol is used. Like plus, a minus operator can also be used additionally as a unary operator. In its case, it's a unary minus, which basically negates an expression. For example, here if x is minus 3, then due to unary minus, the expression minus x will return a positive 3. Just note that unlike unary minus, unary plus does not change the sign of the expression. That is, even if the operand is negative, the expression would still evaluate to a negative value. So unary plus doesn't seem to have any real value. And my guess is, it's only used to visually emphasize that a number is a positive number. Next, for multiplication, a star symbol is used. And for division, a forward slash is used. For modulus, a percentage symbol is used. Modulus operation gives the remainder of division, as we can see in this example, where 5 mod 2 results in a value of 1. Next, let's look at pre and post operators. Let's consider a variable x which is initialized to 5. And first, let's look at post and pre increment operators. And here is an example of a post increment operation. Here first y is assigned the current value of x, and then x is later incremented. So once this statement is executed, y will still be 5, whereas x will be 6. Now with pre increment operator, x is first incremented and then is assigned to y. So both x and y will be 6. Post and pre decrement operators also work in the same way. Here with post decrement operation, y is first assigned the current value of x and then x is decremented. So y will still be 5, whereas x will be 4. With pre decrement operation, x is first decremented and then is assigned to y. So both x and y will be 4. Note that arithmetic operations are applicable to only primitive numeric types. That is, they apply to all primitives except Boolean. Note that we have something called compound arithmetic assignment operators, which basically provide a short syntax for assigning the result of an arithmetic operation to some variable. For example, let's consider this assignment statement involving an arithmetic operation. Now we can rewrite this statement in a more elegant way using a compound arithmetic assignment operator. And it would look like this. Note that here plus is followed by equal to symbol, which means that addition operation is first applied, which is then followed by the assignment operation. Having equal to followed by plus will simply be treated as an assignment operation. That is, no addition is performed, and so plus symbol is simply ignored. So x will be reassigned the value on the right hand side, which is 5. You can actually try this out in your editor. Just try both plus followed by equals and also equals followed by plus. Similarly, we can also have this other compound arithmetic assignment operators. Note that few other operators like bitwise and bitshift can also be represented using compound operators. So that's an introduction to arithmetic operators. Next, we will look at few rules that are applicable to arithmetic operations.